Hello everyone, today we will be looking at the Zooz ZEN17 Universal Relay. This is my first time actually playing around with a Universal Relay. I plan to use this guy to control my driveway gate. Right now I just have a regular clicker and I want to be able to have Home Assistant control it and run automations with it. So that's why I bought this guy. It's my first attempt on using a Universal Relay, so it should be fun. I wanted one that uses the 800LR chip, which Zooz makes, and it's called the ZEN17. So this is pretty much the retail packaging here. So you got the little QR code here that you could scan for warranty information. You do get 5-year warranty. They do firmware updates regularly, so you could check for that too. And it is ETL certified, so it's been tested in a lab. Z-Wave Plus LR S2 authentication. So right here, as you can see, it's got these are the outputs and inputs here. And then this, you can automate anything up to 240 volts, pumps and motors, DC motors, commercial gates, which are what I'm using for, or monitor sensor inputs, water, open and close, and more, and 2 dry contact relay powered by 5-volt USB-C or 12 to 24-volt AC-DC connector. So yeah. Pretty nifty little device. I plan to use it for my driveway gate, so I'm going to do the unboxing right now, and then I'm going to try to get it hooked up to my gate. When I do, I'll show you guys what I did and let you know how it works for my project here. So yeah, so I'm gonna open the box up. So actually back here, when you open it up, it says USB-C is included under the foam. Power supply is not included. Please use a standard USB 1 amp power supply, not a laptop charger. If your Z-Wave hub supports Smart Start, please scan the QR below. So yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and open it up. So you got the plug here, and as you can see, don't use with laptop or tablet chargers. Use with simple 1 amp power supply. So just like a little power brick, probably like something like this that you probably have laying around. I think this one's only 1 amp. Yeah, this is only 1 amp, so something little like this, nothing more, nothing, you don't need anything more than that. So USB-A to USB-C, there you go. And then you got the actual unit here. So as you can see here, this is what the unit looks like. It's a pretty big unit, 4-inch wide, height is a little bit over 2 inches. You got the pair button here, and then you got the contacts for your wires, and then you probably need a flat screwdriver and Phillips to tighten the wires here. And then this is the specs here. Universal relay, that's all the specs here that if you want to take a look at. And on the side, there's nothing on this side, but this side here has the power, DC power, or you could use a USB-C here that I talked about with this cable. And remember, it doesn't come with one of these, so 1 amp plug only. And then detailed pictures, kind of some of the warning stuff here. So that's everything in the box here. So you got your user manual here, so I'm gonna go ahead and just show this real fast. If you want to pause the video, you may. If you want to look at the manual, if you never really played with one of these like me, I'm gonna read the manual thoroughly and make sure that I follow everything that I need to get this guy working. They probably have a PDF version of this online. The Zooz website has a lot of information as well, so you could probably get that stuff on here if you can't read the manual from my video here. So this is everything in the box. You need to provide your own cable, obviously, to connect to your whatever project you're doing. So I'm going to go ahead and stop the unboxing here. I'm going to play around with it, get it hooked up on my gate, and I will let you guys know how that goes. On the second half of the video, this is just the first half of the unboxing video, and let's see how this works. Okay, so this is my old Z-Wave controller that I was using. I wanted to get rid of it because I wanted something newer. And this is the Zooz one that I unboxed. So right now, this is my gate opener for my driveway. And I have the comm wires here hooked in. This comm wire hooked in to this guy here, as per the instruction. And then for power, I just use this guy here and running it to this plug. And this wire here, I'm using for the open and close sensor, is a magnetic sensor. So that's how everything's hooked up right now. So now I already paired it. It was really easy. All you need to do is just hit this button on top three times and just add it to your network. So right now, it sees the relay one and relay two. I'm only using relay one. So now, if I just, let me get out of the way here. If I just hit one, the gate will start opening. And right now, when I hit one, this is the sensor. It should stay in the open position, as you can see. So it's gonna stay open, right? So now when I hit the switch, it's gonna close the gate. So right now, the gate's closing. And I'm gonna hook up the sensor later. I just wanna show you guys. And when the gate completely closes, this will turn off the relay. So I'm just simulating it right now, just so you guys see. So gate closed, magnet, oh, I didn't do it in time. But once it closes, it will turn off. So now the gates, if the gates open, it will, the relay will stay open because there's no magnetic connection. Right? So gate is completely open again. And then I'm gonna turn it, I'm gonna close it. So let me close it. So that should be to open the gate. Relay one, flip the switch, it opens the gate, and the magnet is still open in the open position. And then when the gate completely closes, the magnet will touch each other and then turn off the switch. And then the gate is completely closed. So that's pretty much how this thing works here. It's pretty easy to install if you follow the instructions. And I already have this wire hooked up before from my old Z-Wave unit. So I just transferred that wire over, transferred the power over, and just added this on an open closed magnet here. Yeah, so now the gate's closed, relay's off, gate's closed. So if I turn this on one more time, the magnet should open. And pretty much if I just close it with the magnet, it's just gonna close by itself. It's just like a trigger. So yeah, so it's pretty easy to install. So I just gotta stuff everything in here and then we're pretty much done. All right, this is everything buttoned up. Wire coming out. Then you got the open and close sensor in the back on the gate and on the back of my unit here. And then if you go to the app and hit number one, gate opens. And then on the app, it shows that it turned off. So now we're waiting for the gate to be completely opened. Gate's now open, so now I'm gonna hit the relay on. It's gonna close. And then on the app, you'll notice when it's closing, it's still on. And when this contact magnet hits the contact magnet in the back, it will close it off. That's it. Done. And now you have a Z-Wave controlled front gate. One more time. Then on the app, when the magnet hits, it turns it off. That's it. Yeah, so there you have it. Pretty easy to install. Zooz relay. I just gotta stuff it here and make sure that it's out of the elements. But yeah, if you guys have any questions, just feel free to post below. And there you have it. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace out, next time.